The conduction of electrocardiograms, or ECGs, is a standard procedure performed by physicians to assess the cardiac health of a patient. There are different types of ECG assessments, such as resting ECG, exercise ECG, or also long-term ECG. This video will introduce exercise ECG and the key differences compared to a resting ECG. During a resting ECG, as the name suggests, the patient is at rest, lying on the back. Electrodes are attached to the patient's chest and limbs to obtain the electrical activity of the heart for a duration ranging from 10 seconds up to several minutes. Thus, a resting ECG provides a baseline measurement of the heart's electrical activity. An exercise ECG, also known as stress ECG or cardiac stress test, has the purpose to evaluate how the heart responds to stress or exercise. Often, exercise ECG is used to diagnose coronary artery disease, assess exercise tolerance, and determine heart rhythm changes during physical activity. In an exercise ECG, the patient is attached to an ECG machine via electrodes. But in contrast to a resting ECG, the patient walks or runs on a treadmill or pedals on a stationary bike. The intensity of exercise gradually increases either in a ramp or step protocol. In a ramp protocol, the intensity rises by continuously increasing resistance or speed. In a step protocol, every few minutes the intensity increases about a certain step. What kind of protocol to choose and how the intensity will increase during the test depends on the fitness level of the patient. These parameters should be chosen so that the test duration reaches approximately 10 minutes before the patient is not able to keep up the intensity anymore. During the exercise ECG, it is important to also monitor additional vital signs of the patient, such as the blood pressure. Exercise ECG is often linked to ergospirometry or cardiopulmonary exercise tests, and these three different tests are often mistaken to be the same. An exercise ECG assesses the cardiac function during exercise, ergospirometry assesses the pulmonary function during exercise. And if an exercise ECG is combined with ergospirometry, this is commonly known as cardiopulmonary exercise test, abbreviated CPET. Ergospirometry and CPET will be covered in separate training modules. The most obvious difference between a resting ECG and an exercise ECG is that once the patient is at rest and once the patient is exposed to physical stress, which is meant to increase oxygen demand. Hence, the exercise ECG can reveal heart conditions that might not be evident in a resting state. As the exercise ECG assesses the heart's response to increased demand, it can provide more dynamic information. The electrode setup of an exercise ECG differs slightly to a resting ECG setup. As in the exercise ECG, the limb electrodes are transposed to the torso of the patient to reduce movement artifacts induced by running or pedaling. A healthcare provider might recommend the conduction of an exercise ECG for several reasons in addition to a resting ECG. For example, if coronary artery disease is suspected, to diagnose effort angina, to assess overall cardiovascular fitness, or for monitoring the effects of a treatment or medication. Let's elaborate on some of the key ECG parameters that physicians look at during the interpretation of an exercise ECG. The heart rate is monitored throughout the test and compared to the resting heart rate. Abnormal heart rate responses during exercise can indicate various conditions, such as arrhythmias or autonomic dysfunction. The ST segment is a portion of the ECG waveform that represents the interval between ventricular depolarization and repolarization. Changes in the ST segment, elevation or depression, in the exercise ECG can indicate myocardial ischemia, which is a lack of blood flow to the heart muscle that may suggest coronary artery disease. ST depression reflects the discrepancy between oxygen demand and supply. The level of physical exertion achieved during the stress test is an important indicator of cardiovascular fitness and health. The patient's ability to reach the target heart rate and sustain exercise can provide insights into their overall cardiac function. Monitoring blood pressure during exercise helps identify abnormal blood pressure responses that could suggest underlying cardiovascular problems. Hypertensive responses or significant drops in blood pressure can provide important diagnostic information. The exercise ECG can detect exercise-induced arrhythmias, such as dangerous ventricular arrhythmias or atrial fibrillation, which might not be evident at rest. Physicians also compare the baseline resting ECG with the exercise ECG to identify any new or worsening abnormalities during exercise. As a conclusion, the exercise ECG plays a crucial role in diagnosing and managing heart conditions, particularly those related to coronary artery disease, while resting ECG provides a baseline assessment of the heart's electrical activity at rest and is valuable for diagnosing chronic conditions and routine screenings. Both resting and exercise ECG have their unique roles in cardiology. Often, resting and exercise ECG may be used in combination to provide a comprehensive assessment of a patient's cardiac health.